Right now, we see how student-led protests have their own series, and including university students having coming out and having their own voice and having demands to the government. What's your take in being political scientist and see how active the young generation are like this at this very juncture?
I think it's an exciting moment. And actually what we are witnessing right now is a historical movement. Because if we look at the past of Thai history, the last time that we witnessed the student-led protest is in 1973, the student uprising, the famous event that we call 14 Tula, October 14, right? Since then, the student movement is no longer active and declined. Right? But right now, we see the protest, the largest protest since the coup, right? And led by the youth. So this is something very historical. In every country, if you see a large-scale protest led by the student, it reflects that society has some serious problem, because normally the students, you know, see student or high school student, they focus with their own study that already hard enough for them. They would not have time to go out to the street and protest, right? So the student movement in itself reflect the serious problem and some symptoms of Thai politics and Thai economy. And so I think we should learn from them. We should learn from this phenomenon.
But for more senior citizens or adults or even the authority, probably they are quite alarming to see how students or young generation are very active and having strong demand toward the government. What should the government adjust their mindset in coping with demand from students?
I think the government have to listen to the voice of the youth, also the parent, and also the senior citizens. Because what's happening in Thailand is not unique. We are in an era of change. Everything is in flux because of the COVID-19, because of the globalization, and because of the change of technology. There's a gap in every country between the government and their own citizens. Gap between the older generation and the younger generation, because they have different mindset, different culture and value system. The only way for any society to move forward is to have a dialogue between generation, between government and citizen. The country that successfully create a peaceful space for dialogue between cross-section and cross-sector of population, that a successful country, a successful model that we should learn from. So Thailand, right now, we have all kind of crisis, social, political, and economic crisis. It is very necessary to have a peaceful dialogue among different sectors and between government and citizen. Otherwise, we're gonna be in a trap of, you know, cycle of coup, violence, crackdown on the protester. If this happen, it will plunge Thailand to a more serious conflict. So we have to avoid this violent and extra parliamentary solution. Stick with, you know, a peaceful solution and try to find a way to solve any problem within the system.
Obviously, the move by students are unprecedented and they have been very active, especially on their demand, 3 proposals to the government, 2 standpoint and 1 dream. How do you think of those demands by the students? Are they crossed over the line?
I think if we read carefully on the demands of the student, including that one dream of reforming the monarchy institution, actually our demands are within the constitutional framework of the current constitution. We are under the constitutional monarchy system, right? Not a presidential and republican system. With all the demands of the student is still under this constitutional monarchy framework. And all the demands, if it's going to be achieved, it has to go through the parliamentary process. It has to go through the reform of the law process. So you cannot achieve these demands through revolution or, you know, armed conflict. And students know that, they're aware of this. So they submit their proposal to political parties, to the committees of the parliament. So they seek for change within the parliamentary system, within the constitutional framework. So we should not be too alarming, okay? We can disagree with their ideas. We can disagree with some of their demands, but these are the peaceful protests. These are the peaceful social movement seeking for change through the system. So what we need is a more understanding, a more dialogue between the so-called royalist group or conservative group with the liberal groups. I think it's normal in every society that we have conservative and we have liberal. People can have different ideas toward the, you know, the role of the army, the monarchy, and politicians. We should make it normal for people to exchange on this idea in a peaceful way.
So what should be the next step for protesters to move on from their demand and for royalists and conservatives to take on or to listen to their demands? Should there be mediated space or neutral space in Thai society to really have a dialogue on this issue, especially on One Dream?
There should be. There should be. And I think if not now, when this is a critical moment, and everyone know that Thailand facing, you know, many problems at the same time. But the key and perhaps the most serious problem is political problem. We have to fix political structure in order to create, you know, consensus and, you know, functioning government, in order to fix social and economic problems. So fixing political problem is a key. In order to do this, we need a peaceful dialogue. And I think the media and academic institution can play this role of providing a safe space, peaceful space for dialogue.
What do you read the side of the move by senators that probably they would agree with the changing or amending of the constitution, and with the move by government parties as well? Is this the right signal or the right step for Thai society to move on from this juncture, to move toward amending constitution?
I think amending the constitution or drafting a new constitution is a key, and seems like now we are witnessing a formation of a new consensus. Some senators now agree with the idea of reducing their own power in selecting a prime minister. So they're not against the amending the constitution. Mm-hmm. So this is a good sign. Also, we see that now some, you know, politicians from government parties working together with the opposition parties to submit a, you know, a proposal for amending the constitution. This is also a good sign. So it's a cross section, right, between government and opposition. So it means that consensus is building, is in the process of building. And I hope finally we're gonna reach at some consensus in the near future. We have to thank the movement, the student movement and the people movement, because without this movement and the pressure, I don't think we're gonna see the change of behavior of the senators and the government parties. Now everyone aware. If you are politicians, you sensitive to the, you know, demands of the people, you know that you cannot resist the change. You need to adapt, you need to find a new consensus. Otherwise, the whole system gonna collapse. We don't want that.
If that really happens with the move by senators and government parties, what should be gesture from the government and military after they have got this proposed from senators?
They should make it clear to the public their political stance. For example, the army, make it clear on the rumor about the coup, okay? And the idea of national unity government, okay, which look like another form of coup. So the army and the government should stop this kind of rumors and make it clear that the government and the army would not intervene or against the constitutional amendment. They will respect the decision of the all political parties, including the senators. Okay, so if the government send a strong signal to the senators that you can have freedom to make your own mind, okay, even you appointed by the NCPO after the coup, but now you have to make decision for the public interest.
So that means to close the door of the new coup, it shouldn't happen again ever in Thailand?
Never again. We should have a lesson. Just look at the last two coups. It doesn't bring about peace and prosperity and reconciliation or a good economic development. So both coups create deeper conflicts in Thailand. So coup is not a solution. We should have the lesson. The whole society should have consensus on this. No more coup, and let's find a solution within the system.
And what about gesture from protesters? Should they wait and see what will be the next step of the parliament mechanism, the move by senators and government parties, or should they keep moving on with their demands during their protest?
I think they can do, and I believe that they're gonna do a two-pronged strategy. One is, you know, continue with their protest in order to put a pressure on the political parties and the government. And I think another strategy, I think they're gonna participate and involve in the constitutional amendment process that now taking place within the parliament. Yes. I think that's gonna be a good strategy for the protest movement.
What's your observation from the move by student protesters? Because some adult or some more senior people may not believe that they're coming out from their own independent move. They must be supported by some political parties or some stakeholder who might have gained from their move politically. What's your own observation?
From my observation, and some student leaders are from Thammasat. Some of them are my former students. So from what I know is that they're very confident and very independent. So every move, every decision made by students themselves. The first protest on the Ratchanamnern Street by the Free Youth Yawachon Plot Act happened out of expectation. It surprised everyone. Nobody know that they're gonna call for a protest, right? And after that, I think in every protest, including at Thammasat, Rangsit, on August 10. Nobody knows what they're going to say on the stage. Nobody know about that 10 proposal. So this is a very movement by the students themselves. Politicians, I think all political parties try to catch up with what's happening. They don't have any important roles at all in the movement. So this is a very new kind of movement. It's different from the yellow shirt, red shirt, and PDRC movement that we witnessed in the past 10 years during the color-coded conflict. Those movements are adult movement and have a close connection with political parties, right? Each movement, they have a strong connection, affiliation with the political parties. But this movement is very independent and organic. It's similar to Hong Kong protests by the youth. It's similar to Occupy movement that we witnessed in the US several years ago. So it's organic, it's from bottom up. Yeah. Even myself, the student, they don't listen to me. they don't seek advice from me. They think
you are not their advisor.
Yeah, they saw all university lecturers as too conservative. The agenda for changing the society pushed forward by this student is quite progressive. Actually, all of us, including me, try to understand what really happening.
With the move of the young people, is it too soon for Thailand?
I think
or not soon enough?
Yeah, maybe for students, they think it's too late. And they talk a lot about their future and the future of Thai society. For them, if everything continue in this way, there will be no bright future for younger generation and for all of us. So they don't think it's too fast or too soon. They think it's what happening in the past is too little and too late. And they remember that their parents took them to the protest 6 years ago. And the slogan of that protest is reform before election. For them now, we have election already, but we don't see any reform. So for them now, we need a true reform. We need a radical reform. So the youth is like a voice of consciousness. They awaken us. It's like Greta Thunberg awakened the whole world about the seriousness of climate change situation that we need to act right now. For what happening in Thai society now is that the youth is awakening voice for us, that we need a real reform. We cannot buy time anymore.
So what do you think Thailand should learn or should make the most of this very moment?
I think we are at the crossroad, and at this crossroads with our serious conflict that we are and serious crisis that we are facing, we need a new ideas. We need a cooperation from everyone. So don't marginalize the youth. Don't push them out. And don't use any legal or violent tactic to silence their voice. I think that will worsen the situation and will reinforce the idea that this society has no future for them. So we have to provide a space for them and listen to their voice and have to work together with them. Because in order to go through this crisis now that we are facing is very difficult and cannot be achieved by anyone alone. Government alone cannot help us to go through this crisis. Business sector alone cannot do this. Political parties alone cannot do this. So we need to work together and start from finding a consensus. And I think to have a new constitution that legitimate and fair for all, that would be the starting point.
And what about the students themselves, the young people themselves? What should they do more in order to prove that they are really having strong determination to change society? Because just coming out and protest and shout out loud probably is not enough. Should they do more as well to prove that they really want to work hard for change?
I think it is a challenge. It's a challenge for them. And but I believe that they're willing to take this challenge to prove that they are serious about what they are saying, about what they are fighting for. And to take up this challenge, they have to sustain the movement to show that this is not just a flash mob or just a quick protest, okay, but they're serious to take on these demands and build organization, create a group, or build a social movement to campaign for a social and political change in the long run on the issues that matter to them. Gender equality, get rid of the economic monopoly, reform the education, all these serious issues. I hope that they continue fighting for this in the long term.